Not too long ago, we first came to these chambers. The beginning of this session, we had dreams and possibilities, hopes and wishes. We said to ourselves that we would stake out a claim to do something different for the people of this great state. There was talk that we may raise the age and make sure that people, young people, would not be in inappropriate juvenile settings. We spoke of farm workers may get a day off. Some of us spoke of a religious garb bill. The Dream Act was a part of what we were talking about. Ethics reform. Oh, do we remember ethics reform? We spoke of getting a permanent prosecutor in the case, a permanent special prosecutor, mind you, in the case of police causing a fatal death. We spoke of the leader of my conference being able to go into the room and participate. We had a lot of dreams, increasing the minimum wage, closing the LLC loophole. Well, seemingly those dreams have been deferred. What did we get? Seemingly we've got a bill, we've got about to pass a budget that goes out of its way to embarrass the mayor of the city of New York. Seemingly, the executive has taken great delight in these things. This does not work well for the people of New York State. We need to find a way to work together because these people sent us here to do exactly that. You'd have to work hard to get a worse budget for the people of New York. When you speak of the Rent Act and you speak of a straight four-year extender, you have a series of issues that have been brought up, especially vacancy decontrol, that just not has not been dealt with. We haven't wrestled with that one. If you speak of 421A, we missed an opportunity to create affordable housing. We could have taken that bill, we could have taken that law, and we could have used it to create and help solve some of the homelessness that we have in New York City and New York State. We did not do that. We managed to ensure that those who have will get more, but we did very little to ensure that working people, who simply don't have enough and don't make enough to survive in New York City would have affordable housing. We had a chance to do that. We didn't do it. In fact, we're doing some strange concoction where we're going to let the contractors and the developers and speak to certain unions and come up with something. And this may not even be legal at the end of the day, but we'll see about that as time goes on. If we don't watch ourselves, my friends, we are going to do more to create a type of gentrification in these big cities. And whatever happens in New York City is going to happen in the rest of the state. It's going to happen here first, whether it's something good or something bad. And we could do something about this if we had the will. When we speak of education, mayoral control. Now, I have problems with mayoral control, but I have a larger problem when we pick and choose which mayor will get what. If the norm was giving mayor 7 years, then let's give the mayor 7 years and not the 1 year. What can you really do in 1 year? We have created a type of tax credit that we will have to, you'll have to study this one well. $250 million, if done wrong, we're going to pay for this one. 50 more charter schools. I think that was that card game that I saw on the streets in New York, where you moved it here and moved it there, and who could keep up with it? You created 50 more without moving any. Man, I tell you, that's creative. Then we may be creating a friends and family club with this 15% of the students, where you can fine 15% that can go into the charter schools. Well, there are so many more. I could tell you about the Common Core and how we really needed to address it. Everyone in here knows that the clamoring of the people of New York State over the issue of Common Core, and yet that can we too kick down the street. We put that one off. However, my friends, the hour is late. The president is worthy, so I am not going to speak long. I will say this. I will take this opportunity to encourage my colleagues to think well on what we have done, the good as well as the bad, and to enjoy their break as they go back. Mr. President, I too must vote in the negative on this one.